Liam Williams stops Karim Akara, I think is how you pronounce it, in the second round. Now, this was a fantastic performance from Liam Williams. He looked very strong. He showed great punching power in this fight because the guy he was fighting, whose name I'm not going to try and pronounce, this time last year, he went the distance with David Lemieux. We all know how hard a puncher David Lemieux is. Now, I'm not saying punching power is everything, but it's a nice little statement. When you've been in there with a guy who's never been stopped, has been in there with noted big punchers, and you're blowing this guy out in two rounds, which is exactly what Liam Williams did. Liam Williams landed, it was an exchange. He landed a right hook, punched straight through the target, landed bang on the chin, and his opponent's legs were gone. They were gone, he was out of it. But got back up, another sustained barrage of punches, went down again, and the referee quite rightly waved it off. I think the commentary were saying the corner about to throw in the towel anyway. So it's a nice statement from Liam Williams. He has now picked up the WBC silver middleweight title. The commentary team now said that that will either make him mandatory or it will make him kind of borderline being made mandatory for Jermell Charlo's WBC title. Now, Charlo, realistically, you may as well call him WBA regular champion. That you may as well call him that. Okay? And Canelo being the franchise champion, he's the full champion. What this looks like to me is that the WBC have made Charlo their quote-unquote regular champion to basically take any mandatory obligations off Canelo Alvarez. That's what it looks like from what I'm seeing. But let's head about that. Let's talk about Liam Williams again. Liam Williams, he had his two setback losses to Liam Smith back down to 154. And I actually didn't know. Liam Williams actually turned pro at middleweight and then went down to 154 pounds. So since he's moved up, he's been, you know, reinvigorated. He's shown a lot more punching power, which often can happen. You know, you see it with fighters when they're being really drained of themselves. Like a good example, two good examples would be Naoya Inoue. Look at him when he was fighting at light flyweight. Now, he was still a puncher, but he was going long. He was going, I think he went the distance with someone a few times. And he didn't have the highlight reel knockouts that he had when he moved up. Like, look at him at bantamweight now. He's not drained, and he's knocking people out left, right, and centre. So, definitely Liam Williams. He's a good addition to the middleweight division, I should say. He's looking well. And I think that he could, I'm not going to say he's going to beat these world-level guys, but I definitely think he'll give him a good fight. And I definitely think, I wouldn't be surprised if he could upset a few of these guys. Seriously. Liam Williams is a very, very good fighter. He's a very useful operator. And, you know, I think he could cause some surprises. So anyway, let me know what you think of that down below. Hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please leave a like. Subscribe if you're new. And as always, I will talk to you after.